Hello everyone. In this video, I'll discuss about the J curve and the Marshall Lerner condition. Whenever there is an argument that due to depreciation, there'll be increased demand for exports because exports become cheaper and there'll be more demand for those in the international market and balance of payment will deficit in balance of payment can be overcome this way. But there are few conditions applied, then this will hold true. We cannot say this straight away that due to reduced prices, there'll be increased demand for exports. First of all, of course, there are other things other countries would consider, the quality, of course, the innovations, the features you offer in the products, these kind of things. Then, most importantly, J-curve. Now, what is J-curve? J-curve shows that whenever there is depreciation in the currency, in the short run, the deficit will further deteriorate. It will not improve, it will further deteriorate. And then, in the long run, it will start improving. Why? Because in the short run, the demand for exports or demand for goods and services, that is a bit inelastic, which means countries, those are stuck in different contracts, they cannot immediately change their supplies to another country. For instance, if country A import from specific country and they see those goods cheaper offered by some other country, they cannot immediately switch to those to that specific country. They have to wait until unless the contract is over, then they can switch to that or that option. It means the country which has faced depreciation in the currency, in the short run, they'll be able to sell same number of goods and services to the same countries because of being part of those contracts, and their revenue from the exports would decrease. But later on, after a short period of time, when they'll be over with those contracts, then they can have contracts with the new countries, and due to which there might be more demand for other countries, and in the long run, they will start improve. They'll be able to improve their deficit in balance of payment. And why I have specifically written current account? Because most of the times, this deficit is in the current account that leads to the deficit in the whole balance of payment. That's why I've mentioned here this in the J-curve. Now let's talk about the Marshall Lerner condition. This condition says that the price last year of demand for exports plus price last year of demand for imports should be greater than 1. If we want to give this argument or that due to depreciation things will improve for the country, then this condition should be applied as well. Now what does it mean that elastic demand will be? It means that if price reduces, then there will be increase in total revenue. And in case of inelastic demand, if price increases, there will be increase in total revenue. So if we want that due to reduction in prices of exports, there should be improvement in the balance of payment, then it means the elasticity of demand for imports and exports should be elastic, which means if elastic demand for exports, it means prices would reduce, a lot of people will start buying these products. If elastic demand for imports, it means prices would go up and a lot of people would be discouraged to buy these things. So eventually, this condition will lead to the improvement in balance of payment. And it means, and if this is less than 1, it means it will have inelastic demand, and that means total revenue would decrease. And if it's equal to 1, there'll be no change in the total revenue. So what is favorable for the country if it has a phase depreciation of the currency, devaluation of the currency, that it should be price last year of demand for exports plus price last year of demand for imports should be greater than 1. It should be elastic to have increase in revenue from exports and less demand for the imports, so that there will be better situation for the balance of payment, and there'll be improvement in balance of payment. So this is the argument which is going to cater this idea of devaluation, that it's not always the case that devaluation would improve balance of payment. These conditions would have to be considered whenever we give this argument of devaluation, and that leads to the improvement in balance of payment. Thank you for watching this video. Happy learning.